Hello everyone, my name is John Payne, Technical Marketing Engineer for Cisco Secure Firewall. As part of the 7.3 release, we have introduced updates to our available licenses as well as the performance profile for CPU core allocation. In this video, I will cover those updates to licensing as well as an overview and demonstration of the performance profile feature from the FMC. Getting into licensing updates, in this release, the naming scheme of each license has been changed to better align with the Secure Firewall device offerings. In addition, the carrier license has been added, which allows for the configuration of GTP, GPRS, diameter, SCTP, and M3UA inspections through the use of FlexConfig. Also, the licenses associated with AnyConnect, now Cisco Secure Client, are updated to reflect those naming changes. Keeping in mind, this does not change the function of the features aligned with each license, only the naming has been changed in this release. Getting to the performance profile for CPU core allocation, we have added configuration parameters with the 7.3 release to determine how CPU cores on the device are assigned to two of the main system processes, being the data plane and snort. The data plane handles VPN connections, routing, and other basic layer 3 and layer 4 processing, while snort is the engine providing advanced inspection, including intrusion and malware prevention, URL filtering, application filtering, and other features that require deep packet inspection. If you use the device for VPN or for intrusion and other advanced inspection, you can skew the performance profile so that additional cores are assigned to more heavily used features to improve system performance. In the configuration, you will find four predefined profiles for use with the performance profile, each allocating CPU cores at their respective ratios. Leave the default profile configured if you use a balance of basic and advanced features. The system is designed to provide a balanced assignment of cores to these processes, which this allocation differs based on Secure Firewall device model. Now looking at the FMC, we have a deployment of a single device. Now under the platform settings, we have the option to either add a new threat defense settings policy, or optionally we can add this configuration to an existing policy. Here we'll create a policy by adding a name, an optional description, and assigning the managed device to this platform settings policy. Clicking save brings us to the platform settings menu, where we can click Performance Profile to display the configurable options. The default profile is selected, but when altering the performance profile, a warning message generates stating that a reboot is required for the configuration to be applied. Click Yes to acknowledge the warning, and then we will save and deploy to the device. Now in the deployment menu, there will be a validation warning noting that the configured profile will only be applied once the device is manually rebooted. Click Proceed with deployment and wait for the deployment to complete. Once deployment is complete, we can open a command line session to the managed device where we can verify the configured performance profile with the show allocate core profile command and also initiate a reboot to apply the performance profile to the secure firewall device. Once completed, we can verify changes by navigating to the device management page, editing the device, and navigating to the device tab where the configured performance profile is displayed. This concludes our video on licensing updates, as well as an overview of the performance profile for CPU core allocation as part of the 7.3 release. Thank you.